ladies and gentlemen, we're in Borth. And first of all, my name's Johnathan Lewis, and I used to live just down the road from here. Borth is a weird place because in the summer it can be a fantastic, beautiful, sunny, scenic area. Yeah, that's it. You go on the beach, you know, you go swimming, ice creams. But then in the winter, it can be rough. Now, I'm here in this house of art.
Oh,
it is. It's.
Oh,
it is. No, it is. It's a beautiful and wonderful place. Sadly, I don't know about the person I'm next to. But
not very beautiful at the moment.
Oh, I don't know. But we've known each other for, well, you've known me since I was like
2 years old.
A 2-3 year old who was just a pain in the arse, is that
yes.
right? And I haven't changed.
Correct.
51 now, but we're with Muriel Delahaye, who is I would say one of the best artists in Wales.
Oh, Johnathan.
With her style and what you do. But you also you were very fortunate to meet Lowry, is that right?
Yes, I was.
Now you've met. I think you mentioned in the last video about that one altercation you had near enough with someone who jumped out of didn't get out of a car. I'd love you to
yes.
repeat that because it's just a wonderful story.
He has lots of stories he used to tell to anybody who would listen, I suppose.
Yeah.
No, that one was somebody knocked on his door and he saw a limousine drive up.
Yeah.
With a chauffeur in the front and a very dignified lady in the back who remained nameless. He never said who she was, though he knew.
Right.
But he was such a gentleman.
Hmm. Yeah.
Old-fashioned. Such an old-fashioned gentleman. He never mentioned the name. But the chauffeur got out and came to the door and knocked at the door. And the chauffeur said, the lady would like a painting, and could she have a good one, please? So he just looked at the chauffeur and said, well, I only do bad ones, I'm afraid, and he shut the door.
I love it.
He was...
That is just... It's beautiful.
Well, he was annoyed because the lady, whoever she was, I don't know whether she was a film star or who she was.
Yeah.
But the lady, of course, never moved out of the back of the car.
Hmm.
So he thought... No,
but it's down to earth though, and it's like you.
Oh,
you're very down to earth. You
born in Lancashire, see.
So again, sorry.
Born in Lancashire.
Yeah, well, I suppose yeah, but it's
got to be down to earth up there.
Yeah, well, but I think in Borth you have to be as well. I think if you walk through Borth with a shirt, tie, and a suit on, you would look out of place.
Oh yes, you would. You would think there was somebody. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, either something very wrong with them or they just come out of court.
Yeah.
But tell us about your art. You know, I know the inspiration, a lot of it is about Borth and the sea. And when did your style start? Because I know you've been painting and drawing since the year dot.
Yeah,
but this sort of style, when did it actually start?
Well, I was doing odd little paintings of the sea, which I didn't take seriously at all.
Hmm.
And then I didn't take it seriously at all until I did a painting for the Tabernacle.
Right.
The Theme of Modern Art, to give it its full title, in Machentle.
Mm-hmm.
And they did a summer exhibition with 3 prizes. And I put one in there of this called the Sea, the Sea, and it won first prize.
Wow!
So after that, I thought I'd start doing something, take it more seriously, and do.
Hmm.
And that was what started me off on doing paintings of the sea.
Wow! Because I know you again prior to starting to film, you know you. You said you didn't want to mention names, but I personally think, honestly, that there's no problem in mentioning names, the people who bought them recently, because it's art and they're out there in the public eye anyway. But of course, it's up to you if you want to mention their names. But there are famous people now who have bought your paintings and they're not falling over backwards to get them, but you know, these aren't your regular sort of B and C artists. These are like up there.
What's B and C?
Well, the B and C, the sort of people who you know, desperately try and get on a game show just to be recognised because they were on, I don't know, EastEnders 10 years ago. you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, but who... Would you like to mention a few names or would you prefer not to?
Well, I don't think I should really, but there's Carol Ann Duffy, the Poet Laureate.
Mm-hmm.
Got one.
Wow.
Dawn French has got one.
Wow.
Tara Edgerton's got one.
Wow.
That's the lot,
yeah. There you go. But these people, you know, they're not going to buy any old tat. You know, they're probably buying them for a reason, because like me, I honestly feel your pictures have soul. They've got,
well,
they're alive.
It comes down to money, doesn't it? And then people buy it. It's usually older people that buy my paintings.
Right.
And they're buying them for their children. You know, retired people buying for their children.
Okay.
But you'd have to keep them quite a long time before, if you want to make any money on them.
Right.
For quite a long time.
Well, I've noticed, I mean, again, you've got this one here.
Well, that's called the Fright.
The Fright, got you. And you got that, the...
That's an actual... There's a lady up the road called Elfie. She had Elfie's Cafe up the road.
I know Elfie, yeah, I remember her.
Do you remember Elfie?
I remember her, yeah.
She used to say, I wake up seasick every morning.
Right, so even that doesn't have the sea in it.
Because their windows at the back go right onto,
that's it.
Right onto the beach.
Yeah, Elfie's place in Borth, yeah.
Windows open onto the
So
back.
That's sort of the inspiration from it as well, is it? And also the original picture, The Fright.
I remember the Edvard Munch painting of the screen.
Right, yeah, got you.
Remembering that, well, I thought, if he does the scream, I'll do The Fright.
Right.
There we are.
Because I noticed this one. I think that's absolutely beautiful. Again, it's simple, yet there's a lot of feeling to it. You know,
it's a very old one.
Yeah, but how the boy's sort of looking just slightly to one side.
To be looking up.
Right.
Really looking up.
I suppose, yeah, he's looking up, but it's almost as though...
He's saying, what am I doing here with this bucket and spade?
Yeah,
am I supposed to do with them?
Yeah, or more like, and after I've used them, get me an ice cream. Yeah.
What am I supposed to do with a bucket and spade?
Well, how long does it take you? Let's say behind you now, there's a picture with two people, ice creams. Roughly how long would it take you that size from start to finish?
I do a few sittings of what, 2 and 3 hours.
Okay.
On each one.
And then, so would a painting take 2 or 3 days, or would you paint it over a week?
Oil paint. The beauty of oil paint is you can alter things.
Right.
But it takes a long time to dry.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You have to leave them about a week or so for them to dry.
Okay.
And then you can use a palette knife and scrape off if you want.
Got you.
Off and redo things.
Okay. Is that?
You always see some. Whenever you look, when I see paintings hanging in the galleries or wherever,
yeah,
I look at them and think, oh, I should have, that's wrong.
Yeah, it's too late now, though, isn't it?
You
could always go like with a palette knife and scrape away. I think you're the only one who'd have the artistic right to do that, you know? Anyone else would get hung.
Oh, I don't know, I suppose so.
But they are.
You do see, when you see them perhaps a couple of years afterwards, you think, what was I thinking to do that? You know,
yeah.
See,
but it's probably just how you felt at the time. I think that's the great feature about every painting. They've got their own quirky feel and energy and vibe, haven't they?
Yeah.
Has there ever been a painting that you've done and you've finished and you've sold and then you've just thought, oh my God, that was terrible, or what did
it? You squirt everything.
Yeah.
And then what on earth was I thinking about choosing that as a subject?
Right.
If I do different ones then again.
Yeah. Well, again, this video is about sort of showing the work of Muriel Delahaye, but also you've got a whole bunch here of, I mean, again, these are for sale, aren't they? These are drawings that you've done.
Drawings, yes.
And
some of them I don't want to sell.
No, sure. But again, if anyone ever watches this video and is interested in some drawings, then please, there will be some form of link or information in the description of this video where you can email or get hold of Muriel Delahaye. But there are drawings as well. And then the Scream, for example. I'm just going to doing all this by myself. So, but again, this is the great thing about being real. Okay. Something like that. How, you know, if someone was interested now in that picture, how much would it cost them?
That'd cost them,
$8.50. Okay. And then
that was a two inch frame,
I think. Yeah, of course it would be framed. And then, I mean, this is quite nice. The two gentlemen on a boat. Am I okay to turn this?
Yeah.
There you go.
Shall I come and help?
Hey, I got it. There you go. Because that's quite nice. Are they mackerel?
Yes.
And what price would that be?
That would be $9.50.
$9.50. Okay. Was there any inspiration behind that? Was that?
No, it was just two blokes looking for fish.
Right. That is nice. There is
or
one.
Or seeing fish.
Seeing fish, yeah.
Pass,
yeah.
Past the boat.
Yeah. I suppose they can't be fishing because they haven't got any fishing rods. And then.
Unless they're in the bottom of the boat.
And. True. Didn't think of that. Now, by the looks of that picture, that's some bloke who's taking two bits of totty out.
Yes.
With
him. Yes, or they're having a dangerous landing on the shore.
Got you. Yeah. No, they're lovely. So whereabouts at the moment are your paintings, galleries, where are they? Whereabouts?
Well, I deal with the Mimosa Gallery in Llandeilo.
Okay.
And the Mimosa, by the way, was the ship that took the Welsh to Patagonia.
Wow.
And that's the name of the gallery.
Wow.
And I've also got quite a collection in Libanus,
mm-hmm.
which was an old Welsh chapel.
And that's up the road in Borth, isn't it?
That's on the High Street, yes.
Yeah.
Just up the road in Borth.
Crikey. And then you did have other places, but not anymore, is that right? Or?
Oh, yes, I've done. Over the years, I've exhibited in several galleries.
Yeah.
And the Albany, used to deal with, St David's Hall gallery I used to exhibit in, plus this in Swansea, the Attic Gallery I used to deal with.
Right.
Too many to remember.
So what's your fondest memory of Borth? Yeah.
Well, it's not fun. It's when the sea washed over and came through the back garden.
Yeah.
Do you remember that?
In the 70s, yeah. I can remember because I used to live in Nathaniel, about four doors away down the road. And I can remember, my dad, with a broom, sweeping the water out of the kitchen door.
Yes, yeah.
And it had actually come through the kitchen, the back door.
Yeah. From the front.
From the front, yes. It had gone all the way down the entry
and out
the back, yeah. Because again, Borth, it is a beautiful place, but I have to admit, you know, this time of year you'd look and you think, who the hell would want to walk on the beach? But believe me, after I've been here.
But it's surprising there's nobody walking their dogs because I look out every day and usually see somebody walking their dog along the beach.
Yeah, I'm going to be out there later though because I just love it.
Come rain or shine. Yeah.
Well, all right, I mean, is there anything else you'd like to say? Absolutely anything at all?
I don't think so. I think you've covered everything, Johnathan.
Yeah, I think so.
You've covered everything.
Yeah. But you live to paint. You love it, don't you?
Yes,
you
know, I do. And it's a way of life for me.
Yeah.
Well, it's always been a way of life, really.
Hmm.
I love painting.
And it
occupies your mind altogether and you don't think of anything else. You're just in with the painting.
Yeah.
So all the other price of bananas and all the rest of the rubbish goes away.
Yeah, but in a way that's good because I know today that there is so much emphasis on the news and what's going on and also as well, even though I'm filming you now on a phone, I find too many people now rely on a phone and a small screen and they're not actually looking at their surroundings anymore.
Yeah,
and I truly believe what you're capturing in your pictures is the beautiful energy of the surroundings, and it's captured in a canvas. And, you know, I have some of your paintings and I would far prefer to look at a painting, even though it would never change, and I just get so much good energy from it. I have one which is directly opposite the bed, and it's the paddler.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, and it's just a very simple picture, but that's the first thing I see every morning.
Oh, my goodness.
And I love it.
I didn't know you had it in your bedroom.
Oh, yeah, I absolutely love it. I love it. Well, all right, Muriel Delahaye, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much for letting me into your house.
Well, thank you for...
And filming.
Conversation.
No, thank you very much. And again, if anyone would like to get hold of Muriel or, you know, is interested in any art, well, I think it's I think it's important here, definitely important, because, you know, this is today, it's now, we're in 2018, and I hope this video will be online for many, many years to come. And people will look back and be able to appreciate the beauty of your art. And also anyone who purchases or has any of your art will be able to appreciate it and their family for many, many years to come.
I hope so. Hopefully.
No. They will. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, John.
Thank you. Thanks.